There are quite a few videos on YouTube showing fishing enthusiasts designing fish bait using Fusion 360. In a lot of these designs, you will see a series of rings or ribs along the length of the body. So I thought that maybe I can give this a try and offer my own interpretation. In this video, I will first explain the problems with using the pattern command in this case, and why I think creating a helical path is the way to go. I want to stress that I will only be focusing on creating the rings and not on the main body. I'm going to start with a simple body so that it is easier to understand the workflow, and then we will end with a more complex example. This is just a circular extrude with a slight taper angle. Let's take a look at the problems I faced while using the pattern command. I have a straight line sketch on the front plane. Let's go to Modify, Split Face. Select the outer face as a face to split. For splitting tool, click on the select box and select the sketch line. This creates a split line which will serve as a path for sweeping. Go to Create, Pipe. You can think of the pipe command as a sweep with ready-made profiles. Select the split line as a path. In this case, let's choose a circular cross section. Adjust the section size and set the operation to join. After confirming, you should see a semicircular sweep all along the path. So here comes the interesting part. Because of the taper angle, the diameter of the body decreases as we move along the axis. If we do a pattern, will the pipe command adjust accordingly? Go to Create, Pattern, Rectangular Pattern. For Type, select Features and click on the Pipe feature. For directions, click on the Select box and select the X-axis. Adjust the quantity and distance. Let's try the Optimize Compute option for a start. This gives an error. Let's repeat the command and try Identical as the Compute option. So the pipe feature does repeat, but does not adjust its size. The Adjust Compute option gives the same result as the Identical option. The pattern command allows for selecting of multiple features. What if we include the Split Face feature? Let's go back into the pattern feature. Make sure that objects are selected. Hold down Ctrl and select the Split Face feature from the timeline. Let's try Optimized for a start. Again, this fails. If you try the Identical option, the split lines do get created in the correct fashion, but not the pipes. The Adjust option produces the same result. So it is possible to create a pattern of split lines. But this is still relatively tedious, as a pipe command will need to be repeated for each line. So I would like to propose an alternative method where you use a helical path instead. Perform a sketch on the front plane. Sketch a vertical line as the sweep profile. Make sure that the length of this line exceeds the maximum extent of the body. Sketch a horizontal line through the center to serve as a path. I would recommend to extend this line beyond what is required to reduce the possibility of errors in a subsequent split face step. Activate the surface tab. Go to Create, Sweep. Select the vertical line as a profile. For path, click on the select box and select the horizontal line. The preview currently shows a planar sweep. To introduce twist, we need to adjust the twist angle. Unfortunately, there is no way to adjust this in terms of the number of revolutions. We have to do this by entering multiples of 360. If I want to have 15 revolutions, I can type in 15, followed by an asterisk, and followed by 360. At this point, refrain from pressing Enter, as that will pull you out of the command. As soon as you finish the formula, you should see a preview. Check the preview and confirm. We have created a helical swept surface. We will be using this surface to cut into the body to create a helical split line. Go to Modify, split face. Select the outer face of the body as the face will split. For splitting tool, click on the select box and select the helical surface. Confirm the feature and hide the surface body. We have now created a helical path on the body that adjusts itself according to the tapered surface. Activate the solid tab. Go to create, pipe. Select the helix as a path. Select the section and adjust the size. Since the helical path is a continuous path, you will be able to do this with one single pipe command. Going to the more complex example, we have a starting body that was created by lofting through a series of profiles. In the case of lofts, there is a tendency to create tangent lines. These tangent lines will split the helical path that we create later. Just keep this in mind as we move forward. As with the previous example, create a vertical line that exceeds the maximum extent of the body. For the horizontal line, I will center it on the first loft profile. Use this sketch to create a sweep. Use the surface body to split the outer surface of the lofted body. In the pipe command, because of the tangent line created during the loft, you will not be able to select the helix all at once, even with the chain selection option checked. You will need to hold down the Ctrl key to select the chain of split lines. When it comes to more complex bodies, there are cases where the split face command would fail. I would suggest to try checking the extend splitting tool option. You might also need to adjust the number of revolutions in the sweep feature. I do understand that geometrically, this is not equivalent to a series of rings, but I think that in this case, we have managed to achieve a similar look, which would otherwise require a lot of repeated commands. Hope that this has been helpful. I will see you in the next one.